గవర్నర్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ శ్రీ నరసింహన్ గారు, ఆనరబుల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ శ్రీ చంద్రశేఖర్ రావు గారు, చీఫ్ గెస్ట్ శ్రీ నారాయణ మూర్తి గారు, డిస్టింగ్విష్డ్ గెస్ట్ ఇన్వైటీస్, సీనియర్ ఆఫీషియల్స్ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ, ఇండస్ట్రీ పార్ట్నర్స్, మెంబర్స్ ఆఫ్ మీడియా, లేడీస్ అండ్ జెంటిల్మెన్, ఐఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు బీ హియర్ ఇన్ ద అన్వీలింగ్ సెషన్ ఫార్ ది ఐటీ అండ్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్స్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ పాలసీ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ. ఇట్స్ అ గ్రేట్ ఇనిషియేటివ్. ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కాంగ్రాచులేట్ ది గవర్నమెంట్ ఫార్ దిస్ ఇనిషియేటివ్. యాజ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ నో, డిజిటల్ రెవల్యూషన్ ఈజ్ స్వీపింగ్ ద వరల్డ్ అండ్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఎక్స్ప్లోజన్. డిజిటల్ టెక్నాలజీ ఈజ్ ద ఇంజిన్ ఆఫ్ గ్రోత్. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ ఆర్ అవేర్ ఆఫ్ దాట్ బికాస్ I learned Niti Aayog that every 10 percentage point of digitization is going to increase our economy, what we call as a GDP per capita, by about 0.5 to 0.6%. So what an important portfolio we have to look at. No wonder that our Honorable Prime Minister started the program of Digital India, in which we want to transform our economy to a connected economy in the years to come. Aims of this program are very well known to all of us. Particularly, it is inclusive because one would like to connect more than 2.5 lakhs villages through the broadband highways, public internet access, e-governance, e-kranti, e-health, information for all. All these probably 9 pillars of this particular program all require the initiative in various segments. Investments are also very high because you are going to have something like 1,13,000 crores investment coming in this, and the program will span to bring us into advanced digital economy. That's the major area. Besides this, the program envisages that we should have almost zero import as far as the electronics manufacturing and technology is concerned, which is a mammoth task by any standard. Certainly, the policy which is being initiated by Telangana in sync with the government of India's policy is going to make a great impact, because electronics manufacturing will take us to that particular area. If you look at our contribution today in terms of the total electronics manufacturing segment in the world, the industry is almost about $1.9 trillion today, which is expected to rise to about $2.4 trillion. Unfortunately, our contribution is in single digits in this segment, and our demand is about 100 billion, going to go to something like 400 billion. There's going to be a big gap. Obviously, electronics manufacturing becomes a major requirement. So it's an opportunity, and that opportunity is in all segments, whether it is consumer durables, electronics components, strategic electronics for defense and aerospace, cyber security trusted platforms, electronic manufacturing services, and mobile manufacturing, and so on. However, we cannot continue to do what we are doing for the last so many years. Our value addition in the manufacturing segment has to increase substantially, and we should get out and get beyond the assembly systems which we are doing today. That means we have to generate the design capability. IPR generation has to be improved. There are certain disability factors, and I think the policy which the Telangana government has come out is certainly going to mitigate many of these disability factors, like high cost of power, high cost of finance, high cost of infrastructure, and one of the most important thing, inverted duty structure in many cases, high income tax, special additional duty, central taxes, impact of the WTO/ITA on the zero duty regime. As a result, our component manufacturing came down for almost 50% in 1999-2000 to as low as 20% today. So I personally believe that this policy which Telangana government has brought out is the right step in the right direction, which will mitigate all these disability factors. A quick glance on the policy certainly says that we will have a good synchronization with the government of India's 2012-2013 policy, in which you have preferential market access, we have AMSIPs, we have electronics development fund, and support of HR. I see all of them figuring in the Telangana government's policy, and that's the synchronization between the GOI's policy and the Telangana government. As a result, if we are in a position to do that, then we have good foreign direct investment, a collaboration under Make in India program, and many other opportunities will come. I already see some initiatives like Photonics Valley Corporation being set up, flat panel displays, and I also endorse what Mr. Mohan Reddy mentioned, that the Institute for Internet of Things, cyber security platforms, and certainly good collaboration with the existing defense and aerospace industry which is available in Telangana state today will certainly give us opportunities for setting up more and more startups, incubation centers, and industry partners should be able to avail this opportunity. I once again like to congratulate the state government, the Honorable Chief Minister, the Honorable Minister for IT, and all the team Telangana which has made this event feasible and given us great opportunity to showcase the skills of Telangana as a state in the electronics and IT sector. Thank you very much.